to take right now, the latest interest rate decision from the Federal Reserve. And we are hearing, very much as expected, that the Fed leaves the rates unchanged in a unanimous vote. Fed inflation, they do talk about, of course, inflation to rise this year, stabilize at around 2% medium term. They also say that the economy to warrant further gradual increases in rates. So let's take a look at what is going on right now. The markets, not too much of movement, a little bit to the upside right now. But we should also take a look at the U.S. dollar if we can, or at least the U.S. 10-year yield. U.S. 10-year yield not moving much. It was 2.33 when we started. It's 2.77. It's now 2.727. So in other words, not too much of movement there. As you can see, though, there's a little bit of a hawkish takeaway, it looks like, actually. Let me take a look at it a little bit further here. Leaving rates unchanged, inflation to rise this year, stabilize around that 2% medium term. Again, not too much movement on that U.S. 10-year yield, if anything, maybe even a little bit lower. For more, let's now bring in my guest. I've got Brian Belsky joining us. Brian, good to be with you. I was reading this kind of the opposite way, that TLT is actually moving up, rates are moving a little bit lower. So it's not as hawkish as the market was starting to expect.
Well, I think there's been, good afternoon, Canada. I think there's been some mixed signals here as of late with dollar weakness that people were confusing with respect to what's happening with economic growth. I think the number one theme that many people want to speak to us at least about inflation, quite frankly. And what we see, what our great economics team at the BMO continue to see is more along the lines of wage inflation potentially being more of an issue, let's say, down the line a few quarters from now. That's why, from an intermediate basis, it still looks to us that growth remains very positive. The Fed remains on track and track for at least two more rate increases. And I guess maybe more, the better way to put it, Catherine, is there's got to be proof in the pudding with respect to when companies actually start to put this potential money to work with respect to the tax cuts and growing earnings again.
You know, I think one of the areas maybe that's getting attention in terms of why this isn't as hawkish as the market was starting to expect is because of their outlook for the economy.
Yeah.
They say, they repeat the risks to the outlook appear roughly balanced. Roughly is what they talked about last time. I think some people were expecting that they could talk about it being balanced, taking out that word roughly. I mean, those are the nuances that we're talking about here. That's why you're not seeing too much of a move in terms of the market reaction. But if anything, the move is slightly to the dovish side. Would you agree?
Yes, on the onset. Now, remember, too, that the market or the stock market or in terms of participant companies in the stock market, many investors have kind of missed this move into value, missed this move into financials as interest rates have moved higher, okay? And so there tends to be a lot of back and forth on an almost daily basis in terms of what these moves in interest rates, the yield curve, the dollar actually mean. And the more negativity you see with respect to some of those comments, quite frankly, is because, Catherine, they missed the boom in financials. So I wouldn't take too much into this. I don't think that any major change was expected with respect to the commentary from the Fed. And let's see when the new Fed kind of completely takes over as we start to see that roll out longer in terms of this year.
And this was very much viewed, this meeting today, finishing up today, very much viewed as a placeholder for what might take place in March, which is an expected rate increase with three rate increases expected for 2018.
Remember, 2017, you know, post the election, 2017 was really a watershed year as we kind of moved out from, let's say, crisis levels